Hello colleagues, in this video I'm going to show you how to generate climate product or how to extract climate products from ClimSoft. First you need to log in into ClimSoft using your username and password. And then you need to select the icon for climate product. So before we move further, you need to know that climate products in ClimSoft can be presented in two different ways, either in a tabulated data product format, this is in CSV text file, or in graphics format. This will give you a line or a chart, a line or a bar chart. This can also give you a windrows picture. So under the product list or product categories, we need to select one of these. So let's start with the data product. So under data products, there is a variety of sub products. Minute data, hourly data, daily data, pentad, decadal, monthly, annual, means, and so on. And here, let us start. You can start with the minute observation data. Here, you select the station by tapping the one or two initial letters or characters of your station. So mine is this one. This is an automatic weather stations. I mean station. So I just want to select one with a parameter for wind speed, and direction. So you can decide to use the element code, or you can select from the drop-down list. So that's it. So you can decide to use the drop down list, or you can decide to select the station. Okay. So you can clear this. And then here you type the station code, I mean the element code of your interest. So I want to use wind direction average and wind speed average. And then this is minute data. So for the wind, it will use the by default. This one is the mean will be used. So here you need to select the period of interest. Like here, my data start in 2013. End of the month, December, and then my data ends in 2015. So that's it. So I've specified the period of interest, and then by clicking on the start extract or start extraction, the system will be to give, it will be able to generate the output file in the comma separated value or CSV text file. So let me click on start extraction. This also will depend with the speed of your computer and the amount of data you are extracting. So give it a time. The system is generating the output file. As I say, the output file will be generated in comma delimited value or comma separated value. This is a text file. So here is my file. So my file has been generated. As you can see, it has also alongside the metadata, station ID, station name, lat, long, elevation, and this is now the year, month, day, hour, minutes. As you can see, my station is, my data is 10 minutes, 10 minutes, and this is wind direction in three numbers or in three digits, and wind speed in meter per second in two digits. So that it. So this is an output CSV file which can be used in other application or can be used in further analysis. So that it. So this is minutes data. More especially, this come from the automatic weather stations because it has got so many details. As you can see, this was minute data. You can also generate hourly data from minute data. So this is hourly summary. And to do this, you can close this dialog and select on the hourly summaries. Select the same station by tapping initial. Put the elements 895 for wind direction, 897 for wind speed for automatic weather stations. As you can see, this is hourly data, and because this is wind data, it will select the mean. Then we specify the period of interest, 2013. Here this is 2015, December, of course, and then end of the month. That is so, and then once we click on the start extract, the system will generate an output CSV file that can be used in further analysis. So this is hourly data, as you can see, alongside with the metadata, of course. So for this day, for different hours, and so on and so on and so forth. So further to this, you can also generate daily data from your data. So you can also go further and generate daily data. If I click on the daily, select the same station, select the same elements, and 87. And here I want daily data for the automatic weather stations, so daily summaries. So from which period you specify 2013, 2015, type the number here, 12 mean December, end of the month 31, and then you can decide to transpose so that the data may be put in the transpose mode, and then you select on the start extraction. So in this case, the data will be in the transpose mode. So that it. So as you can see, my data from day one up to the end of the month. It's in transpose mode. So if you don't want to transpose, you can do this, and then if you extract again, so now my data will be in one column. So as you can see, we need direction average is one column, and the wind speed is one column. So that it. You can go further and further. Let's say you want monthly data. You can also be able to generate monthly data for the same station. And maybe for the same parameter or different parameters. So this depends with the data you have in your system. This will still specify the summary type. This is the mean. Specify the period 2013, 2015, December, end of the month. And here you click on Start Extraction to display your monthly data from automatic weather station. So this is monthly summaries. So each month, September, October, November, December, and so on, for wind direction and wind speed. So here I've been using automatic weather stations, but here I can also generate for manual stations. So if I say I want like daily data for another station, a manual station, you type the initial for the station, you select the station, and you want like a maximum temperature, minimum temperature. You want also precipitation. So by selecting the code elements, you will move faster. So my data will start in 1971 to 1990, December, end of the month. So here is my daily data for this period, many years. So since this is daily data, so you don't bother yourself with the mean or whatever, it will just display daily data. If you click on Start Extraction, the system is generating the data file output. So as I say, the speed of your computer will matter on the range of periods. So it will display three columns: maximum, minimum, and precipitation for your data. So that it. So this file can be used or can be served to a customer who wants data. You can also generate other type of products. Like I've said, let's say I want to generate for precipitation only for the same period. So you can also decide to transpose. It is up to you. So the system will display this file into the transpose mode from day one up to the end of the month. So you can scroll down. Years are here. That's it. So this is my file. From 71 up to the end of 1990. So this is one way of displaying climate product in CLIMSOLV. This is tabulated data product. Now, there is another way of displaying climate product, which is in graphics mode. Now, under graphics mode, we have three types. You can have either wind rows, you can have a time series, or a histogram. So this one will display a line chart, and this one will display a bar chart. So let's start with the wind rows. As we are aware, wind rows use wind direction and wind speed. So let's display the wind rows for our data from the data for our automatic weather station. So by default, the elements for wind for to produce wind rows is known. The system will pick it by default. What you need to do is just to specify the time range. So my file starts from 2013 up to 20. Let's say stop at 2014, December, end of the month. So I want to draw my wind roads using this station and at this period range. So if you click on start extraction, the system will ask you want to display data wind road, to draw wind road from which data, either wind data from AWS. If it is for AWS, you said yes, so the system has said it is. If no, if you click no, it will use the wind element for the manual station. So, but since my station is an AWS, I said yes. I say yes to allow the system now to draw the wind rows using the AWS data for this station. So you give it at a time. You give it a time depending on the amount of data and the speed of your computer. The system will be able to display your product depending on the amount of data you're extracting and the speed of your computer. But generally, it will not take a lot of time. So that's it. So we are drawing. So the system is drawing a wind rose, which can be used for further analysis or for further interpretation. As I said, this will depend with the amount of time. So as you can see, it is I'm using. Yes, so this is the product we want. So this is your Windrose. So this Windrose, you can import this picture in your presentations, so in other presentations, or you can save it for further use. So this is a Windrose graph. You can also be able to view other type of graphs like this one. This is a histogram graphs, which shows you the prevailing wind direction. So that's it. So this is, this prevailing wind speed. This prevailing wind speed. So it can also, this frequency distribution as well is also available. Frequency in counts and so on. So that's it. So this is how to display the wind rose. So besides the wind rose, ClimSoft is also able to give you other types of charts. Like I said, this is a time series chart. If you click on it and you select like one of the stations, let's say this station, what do you want to display under the time series? Maybe you want to compare maximum and minimum temperatures, the variation of minimum and maximum precipitation. Since this is temperature, we need to select the mean. We should not do the total because this is temperature. So select the range of your data. It's 1971 for me. Here you can go up to 1990. December, just type 12 and the end of the month. And here now you will be able to, once you click on the start extraction, you will be able to produce a time series chart. So this dialog, you need now to specify, you need to draw which time series chart, for daily, for monthly, or for annual. Since we are using many years, we need to take the annual. Want to know the annual variation of the minimum and maximum temperature and select on the plot. So the system will display this chart. So here now you can put the title can say maybe, T max and mean, T mean. Temperature variation. As you can see, when you are typing, the title is going on top. And X axis, you have the years. Y axis, we have temperature. So this is in degree Celsius. That is, so you can decide to improve on the lines, produce, then colors, and then the top for the maximum for the third one. So that's it. So you can decide to improve on the colors. And then here you can decide to save this so that you can use it later, or you can import this in other applications. And you can select here the format: PNG, JPEG, GIF, TIFF, BMP, and so on. That it, so you can decide to print it directly local, or you can decide also to view the data which was used to display the chart. You can also use the help button to get more information on the climate product. That it, so this is time series online chart. So you can also be able to display or to produce the histogram chart by clicking on the histogram. Select the station. Select your parameters. Let's select the precipitation. And here we precipitation is normal in total. Select the year 1971. Let's say we want to see the variation of precipitation in the year December, end of the month. So we just want to check the variation of the precipitation in 1 year. So by clicking Start Extraction, this dialog will pop up. Now you need to specify. So here you can say I want annual, I mean monthly, and then by clicking on the plot, the system will be able to draw this bar chart or histogram, which shows you the variation of precipitation throughout the year. As I said, you can give the title. Maybe you can say Kigali. Rainfall. Yeah, so monthly rainfall variation in 1971. X-axis month, Y-axis is precipitation in millimeter. That's it. So yeah, so you can be able to save this graph so that you can, this can be used in other presentations. You can be able to print this. You can also be able to view the data used to draw this histogram. You can also get help. Then you can be able to close this chat or this dialogue. So that's it. So thank you so much for watching. In my next video, I will go further to see other types of products. So in my next video, I will show you how to do now the inventory product. So keep watching and see you then next for my next video. Thank you.